about 6:45. It's Thanksgiving Day, Thanksgiving morning of November the 26th. I'm at the Harry F. Byrd Senior Visitor Center, Shenandoah National Park, and I'm going to embark on a hike, a 6.4-mile loop on the Rose River Store the Forest Trail, is what it's called. Quite chilly this morning as well, so I want to get an early start on my hike. So here we go. If I read the information about this particular trail, there are two waterfalls. And then initially, I am going on a descent. Temperature is probably about, I'm just taking a guess, about 45 degrees. It's supposed to warm up today, around getting close to 60, maybe 65 degrees around noontime. I am not sure how long it's going to take to do this hike. Hoping I'd be done with it by 1 p.m. And I've only scheduled one hike for today. And I suppose that on Thanksgiving, this being Thanksgiving Day, the park might be getting full. And as you saw it back there, the parking lot was empty. I'm usually the first one out here when I do a hike. And by the time I return to the parking lot, it's getting full. And also on the way back, if it's an in-and-out hike or even on a loop, there are individuals who I meet on the trail going in the other direction. So they're starting their hike as I'm finishing mine. And I will probably be going through Dark Hollow Falls again. If I read that sign back there correctly. I believe Dark Hollow Falls was my very first hike out here in the Shenandoah National Park. I find using the All Trails app is invaluable. I highly recommend using that app if you're doing any type of hiking. It has kept me on the trail. It alerts me if I get off the trail, and I can actually see my progress on the app itself. So, very handy. What's nice about it, with the pro version, you can download various maps. The All Trails app, the All Trails map, the topographical map, satellite map, different maps, and you can use them offline. So if you don't have cell phone service, no problem. All Trails will still work, that's the pro version, if you download the map. And so I have the Rose River Store of the Forest Trail map downloaded on my iPhone 11. And I'll consult it every now and then to see where I am along on the trail. But I make it a point to take advantage of reasonable hiking weather. And what's reasonable depends on what you can take. I can hike in the snow if I had to, or if I wanted to. The problem would be driving from where I live in Fredericksburg up into these mountains, and the roads are slick. So it's not so much the trails, it's getting here. So I want to take advantage of the good weather and also the fall colors while I can. The fall really is my favorite time of the year. Okay, I've come to a fork. Now I can go this way to the left. There's a blue blaze there. I can also go to the right. If I go to the right, I'll be taking the trail or the loop counterclockwise. If I go to the left, I'll be taking it clockwise. And that's going up. So either way, it's up to you. I'm gonna take it to the right here and go counterclockwise on the trail. I'll get to the waterfalls toward the end of the hike. So I'll be going down for quite a while here. So I'm gonna be crossing Skyline Drive. Assuming this is the way to go. I double checked my All Trails app and this is correct. I'm going in the right direction, taking the clockwise loop. And again, you can go either clockwise or counterclockwise. And what I meant was I've taken the counterclockwise loop. come to a fork. And there's a trail going up that way. And based on my app, I should be going down. So I'll go this way. And I see a blue blaze on that tree directly in front of me. Now I'm seeing more saturation on the trail, but it's still not too bad. You just have to take it easy. Common sense. Please do not attempt hiking these trails. Whether the ground is saturated or dry, get dress shoes. Don't do that. Get yourself, invest in some quality hiking shoes or hiking boots. And get yourself some trekking poles. It's my recommendation. There's something about trekking poles. If I could make an analogy, it's like putting your vehicle in four-wheel drive. They do make a difference. I've been on this trail before, Dark Hollow Falls, so when I continue on down, I will eventually get to Dark Hollow Falls, and then I'll continue on from there. And the reason why I know I've been on this trail before is because I recognize that bridge up ahead. And if I'm not mistaken, once I cross that bridge, I'll be taking a sharp right-hand turn. Okay, mud, no problem. I'll go around it or I'll go through it. I always try to go around it as much as I can. If I can help it, I'll go through it. Yep. Dark Hollow Falls at the bottom of this incline here. Lots of steps going down. No problem. Taking it easy. Temperature is a little higher now. That combined with increased body temperature because I'm moving. Yep, there's Dark Hollow Falls. Last time I was here, this trail was pretty crowded, but I haven't seen one person yet this morning. Last time I was here was about 2-3 months ago. And this was as far as I took it. I came down this path over here, stopped here, checked out the falls, and went back up again. This time, I'm going this way to continue on with my loop. But this right here, this is Dark Hollow Falls. Pretty cool, that bridge down there. Yellow blazes on this tree. Yellow blazes, I believe that means a horse trail. And this looks like something that you would hitch your horses up to. And the trail is wide enough for horses. I definitely agree. Stay on the trail, folks. Too slick out there. So I believe this is the way I need to go. Excellent. So I have two options here. I am going to stick with the first one. The Rose River Loop Trail, Fisher's Gap, 2.9 miles. And the Rose River Fire Road, that's 5.5. So I am going this way. some deer out there in the distance. A stream crossing. Just going to check it. Be careful here. Thank you. Interesting. I don't think the trail goes that way. I hope not anyway. All right, here's a blaze. More than halfway on the trail. It's been pretty good. had a downed tree blocking the trail. I had to crawl under it. I had some nice camping spots off of there. Somewhat flat. Okay, I'm back. I got off trail slightly. I got to a section of the trail that wasn't really marked very clearly. But a nice gentleman by the name of Hugh, he's a section hiker, came along and he helped me out. He's ahead of me right now. I'm about a mile and a half from the trailhead, that's Big Meadows. The weather is pleasant. I see some clouds moving in. We might get a little bit of rain, I don't know. But it's still nice out here. I can't think of no other place right now I'd rather be than out here, given the circumstances with the global health crisis. Might get some rain. I hope I make it back to the parking lot before it rains. But I'm not fretting it because I have my rain jacket in my backpack. I'm going through a picnic area. As you can see, I'm on a paved road. And I'm just following the directions of my All Trails app, so I'm going in the right direction. I read someplace on All Trails on one of the reviews. It said to take, go in the area between 10 site 21 and 24. That there'd be like a clearing. And this sort of like looks like that. And up ahead, I do see a concrete marker.
Let's see what it says. The All Trails app, rather, indicates that I'm on the right path here. Let's see what this says. If there's anything on there at all. I don't see anything. I'll just go straight. This trail could be marked better. Man, that looks like a beautiful campsite over there. It's gorgeous in there. The All Trails app says I'm going in the right direction. Whoever wrote that review on All Trails had it right down to the letter, because straight ahead I see a blue blaze on the tree confirming my All Trails app. I am very close to Big Meadows parking lot. I think it's all flat here on out. It's beautiful out here. Didn't see a whole lot of people. There you go. Looks like a freshly painted blue blaze there. I'm now emerging out of the Rose River Trail. I can see the parking lot off in the distance, and I can even see my vehicle. I know that I did more than 6.4 miles because I got off trail twice. For about, I say, a total of about a quarter of a mile, not too far off. So this hike encompassed two waterfalls, the Dark Hollow Falls. Waterfall is the first one that you will see. If you get on this trail and you go counterclockwise, and then the second waterfall, I suppose it's called Rose River Falls. the trail, in my opinion, is not very clearly marked. You can definitely need y'all's trails app or gut hook, whatever you want to use. But other than that, no issues with this. Let me check the time. It's 12:45 and the parking lot is nowhere near full. And looking up at the sky here, there's some dark clouds, but I don't think it's gonna be raining anytime soon. I have time to change to something comfortable for my drive back home.